So we're doing the final top off on the pond. And as we add the water, we want to be careful to not have chlorinated water before we put tadpoles in. I've collected some tadpoles from one of the other frog ponds on our property, and want to make sure they're real sensitive to chlorine. So we're going to dechlorinate the pond. And I just got this dechlorinator. Since there's no circulation system, I'm going to sprinkle it in there, and then I'll use the hose water to kind of stir it up a little bit. Now, since the pond's brand new, I also want to kickstart the pond with some beneficial bacteria as well. And I'll do the same method. I'll just take a little scoop of it, sprinkle it around, and then circulate it around with the water that I'm using to top it off. Now, if you're collecting a bunch of tadpoles from a small pool that's drying up, and I'm not encouraging you to just go run around and collect tadpoles everywhere, but if there's a puddle that's drying out, if the water's evaporating too fast, and you know the tadpoles aren't going to morph before they before the water dries out, then we want to save them. Or if you have some friends that have some on their property, maybe you can establish your property with them as well. So I want to be clear on that. But if you do a new pond like this and it's not established yet, you don't have an ecosystem, you don't have the biofilm and algae growing in there yet, you're going to need to provide these guys with some food. So that's why we're putting submergible plants in there like anacris, but I'm also going to have some little bit of flake food on hand for the first season, so I can throw in there and they can have something to nibble on while the pond establishes. So now that we have the pond treated and I have some food here, now we're going to go ahead and enter these guys into the pond. I have some mosquito fish in here as well, so that way they'll eat the mosquito larvae that might show up because the frogs won't be able to get to them. Okay, let's do that next. So it's a wrap. I hope you enjoyed our frog pond demonstration that my son and I did in just a couple of short hours. I want to review with you some of the benefits of having a frog pond on your property. Number one, if you do it correctly, you're going to have a beautiful water feature as long as you take the steps that we showed you in this video. Number two, you're going to reduce the amount of insects that are on your property when you have a nice frog population hanging around everywhere. Now, three, and most important, you're going to do your part to help save this wonderful creature. Because of a rare disease and declining habitat, these really are becoming an endangered species. So we're off to another project, and until next time, I'm Eric Triplett, the Pond Digger. Thanks for watching.